Stop modeling in 3D, organizing plans, or even labeling facility elements as you have done until now. If you find it difficult to reach your deadlines, today I invite you to explore with us four specific artificial intelligences for Revit that we have put to the test. Do you like to rush through your projects? Well, you are going to love this video. So before I start, there are two honorific mentions that I'm going to make. First one is about this Evolve Labs Glyph application. I'm not going to purchase it and I'm not going to try it in this video. Why is that? Well, because I already did. And in fact, I had it for several months without actually using it. The reason is that it is promising to make automatic dimensions. It does the automatic dimensions, but they're not very professional, they're not very smooth, and they do not fit where I want them to go. So where this application is concerned, I still prefer the applications that we do in BoldBrain, either with Dynamo or with Python, and where I get my dimensions exactly where I want to. Here I'm going to mention it, but I'm not going to test it yet again. And the other one which deserves a special mention, I can't test this because it's not for test yet, but it does look good. I'm going to book a demo with this team because it's called Pipe It, and it is supposed to find you the best paths for pipes without clashing. And I think this is very promising because nowadays there are very few applications for MIP where Revit is concerned, and I hope to see more and more every day with artificial intelligence. The first application I'm going to be showing you is PlanFinder. PlanFinder is an artificial intelligence that distributes the floor plans. So it's very useful for those of you working in, especially in residential buildings, because it saves us a lot of time from the distribution and thinking the plans and rethinking it and thinking about the uses. So I think this artificial intelligence will be very useful for architects that are in the design phase. Let me show it to you. Now, PlanFinder only works in English and it's really simple to use. First, you have to go to PlanFinder and you have to press Fit or Generate. If you press Generate and click Finish, here we have some options. So the first thing that we may notice is that when we click Generate, we have here the door where it should be and a possible distribution. But if we go here to this little square, we have several different options in order to explore. So I may see that here I have like a corridor with a Zeta form, and however, here there's an option which has less corridor, and these two seem also the same, very symmetrical. So let's pick one of these, and as you can see, this has already changed. Now, if we want to change a certain room, we have to click the room and it will be distributed differently, which I think is really cool. And once we have decided our ideal design, we can click OK, and then our plan finder will furnish our house. Not only furnish it, but also include the walls and the divisions. Here we have our distribution, and if I go to my 3D, I can see how this fits. Now, evidently, this is not perfect. For instance, here I have a wall with a window, and it has included a closet just in front of the window. So this may not be the best choice. So later, we have to go over the plan, change whatever doesn't fit. So for instance, right, so that distribution wasn't the very best for the windows. So right now it's better distributed. So we still have to think as architects in order to work hand in hand with the artificial intelligence, but I think this is quite a good application. So the next artificial intelligence application I want to show you, it's called Smart Annotation. And Smart Annotation promises to draw the tags without overlapping, without each tag overlapping another. I tested this with different results. It does take a long time to run. This is a warning. It takes a couple of minutes to run and the results may vary. I did a first composition in which all tags were overlapping each other. This wasn't the best result I got out of this application. However, on a second run, trying for a different scale and testing a different setting, I got this other result, and this result was way better. So tags are a complicated thing where map is concerned, because we do have to include a lot of information on the plans. So I think this application is worth it when it works. However, be warned, it does take a lot of time to run. These results were quite good on the second run, and with a different configuration and with a bigger scale. So do I recommend this one? Yes, I do. Now on for the next one. Now, one of my favorite artificial intelligence applications for Revit that has been released this year is WiseBeam. I'm going to show you how it works. I have already tested this in the Spanish channel that from now on should be automatically translated to English with every video. So you can check it out right here. But I'm going to show you how it works. So for instance here, I have a floor plan and this is a PNG, this is an image. But you can also have PDFs or CAD files. So when I go to complements and select WiseBeam, it tells me to detect. The quality of your plan is low, did you set the scale before launching? And I click accept. Now, what this application is going to be doing is that it will draw the 3D model according to the plan. So let's launch that and let's see how it does. This image is low resolution, so it might not get the best result. This becomes better the more resolution you have. So for instance, if you had a high resolution image, then if you had a good PDF, and the best results come from the CAD files. So it's already done. It says we have 28 walls, 8 windows and 6 doors. And if I close this, I can see the result now. Now it's not perfect, but it has drawn the plan exactly where it should have drawn it. So if we check it up, we can see in some cases we have windows where there should be doors, but the result for a low resolution image is quite good. And with a CAD file, the results are even better. So this application is one of my favorites because of all the time it saves up, because you no longer have to draw the walls and the windows and the doors by copying a floor plan. Okay, this last artificial intelligence I'm going to explore is Veras for Revit. And this is the only application I'm bringing to you that's all about render. But careful, it's render directly connected with Revit. This is not about, yes, I'm taking out the image in Revit and then importing it into my webpage. Nothing like that. We are working straight in Revit. So this is the image. I have already tested this with Prom AI. And as we open Evolve Lab, here are the presets. So none of them look quite similar to what I want to achieve. So let's take this one, the Bristol board model. Let's go to compose, and I'm going to introduce exactly the same prompt that I did when testing Prom AI, which is minimalist concrete house with big glazed windows and a pool. And let's click render, and here is it. Not bad at all. Even though it tried to include a bigger pool round here than the one I really wanted, which was right here. And I don't know why, but it somehow skipped my wall. I don't know why that happened. But overall, it's a really good image. If you take a closer look, you can even see the different textures of the concrete. So overall, it's very good for an application which is directly connected with Revit, which makes it much more comfortable than other options that are on the internet. If I click edit, let's see whether I can have my wall back. Look, here I have a tree on the background. When I worked on the Spanish version, this tree was actually a chimney. It was worse the first time, so it seems like the model is learning. Let's try for a second render with this selection and see what happens. Okay, so it actually made it a little worse because it tried to force... I don't know what it tried to do here, really. It tried to force a wall there, but it really didn't work out. So I think the edit option really has a long way to go. So overall, I showed you a lot of artificial intelligence application specific for Revit. And I would say that Plan Finder deserves an honorable mention in fourth place because it's really useful when composing floor plans. On the third position, I will include Veras because being the only AI tool specifically for Revit and rendering makes it really special. On second position, I will include the one about the tags. Why is that? Because I really think that once you have your setup clear, it's one of the most useful applications for MIP. And lastly, on first position, I would choose WiseBeam, because WiseBeam is super useful when you receive either an image, a PDF, or even a CAD file, and it saves you tons of time. What do you think? Do you know any other artificial intelligences specifically for Revit? If so, please mention them down below in the comment section so I may take a look at them. And of course, you may check up our artificial intelligence list on YouTube. And please, please, please do subscribe to the channel. It's free and it helps us tremendously to know that you do love our videos. See you on the next one. Bye bye.